So the final match here of day one of two here at the European Top 16 in Montreux. Battle between two players who, let me say, have history. They played five times head-to-head. Samara's 3-2 in the lead. Han Ying, a brick wall of defence. As soon as you give her a loose ball to her forehand, she's incredible at attacking. She punches with the backhand too. Such heavy spin. I'd honestly have to play against it to try and lift it to tell you how much spin is on it, because it's... I mean, if a professional player struggles to lift it, I don't know what an amateur or intermediate player could do with it. They'd probably hit their side of the table before it even hit the net. The last time these two played was 2019, which Han Ying won 4-3. Samara, a former European champion from 2015. Incredible legend of Europe, as is Han Ying. So this is a match of two really experienced players who I'm sure will know each other's games really, really well. Samara has incredible hands. She's good away from the table in the loop-to-loop rallies. Fantastic fade forehand. She's going to have to put to some good use here against Han Ying. Han Ying is the queen of chopping rhythm. First touch from Samara was beautiful. Misses the dummy loop. And by dummy loop, I mean a loop that slows the pace down instead of goes for full power. Samara missing a few cheap forehands, gifting them to Han Ying. But it always takes a little bit of time to get used to the defensive opponent, especially if you played an attacker in the previous round. There's that fade forehand to slow things down. Wow. Whoa! Sensational, and a cheeky reaction from Samara. Beautiful point. Leaves the door open and Samara walks right through. To chop, Samara waiting for an opportunity to attack, which she finds but can't execute. Two left-handers against right-handed choppers on both tables. Table two, Timo Boll against Wang Yang. Live right now. Whoa. Well, there was about four shots in the space of a millisecond there. Insane reactions and focus from both players. Ooh, unreturnable net court. Samara's had a few nets, but she needs them right now. Eight, nine. Wow, look at the relentless power chipping away at that defensive wall. Oh, oh well, I've lost count of how many nets she's had there. But nevertheless, she's done well to come back into this. 9 points all. Can Han Ying remain composed, knowing that she's been really unlucky? Well, and completely against the run of play, up to press. Samara now has a game point. 9-10. And she does it. She steals game one and has the momentum with her now going into game two. Han Ying will be disappointed she couldn't put the icing on the cake. So Elisabeth Samara stealing game one. She had a bit of fortune on the way, but she stayed mentally tough, composed. Han Ying couldn't finish what she started. See if she can brush that under the carpet. She's just been to the toilet, I'm not sure what for. Whether it was to rewrap a bandage or... either option doesn't really need explaining. Very decorated player, Han Ying. 3 golds, 1 silver and 2 bronzes at European Championship events. Obviously got that bronze in the Olympic Games back in 2016. Should I say silver? To my knowledge, didn't actually represent Germany at Tokyo. Some are even more decorated in Europe. 8 gold, 7 silvers and 5 bronze. Singles champion in 2015. Won many women's team matches. Nice from Han Ying. Bringing that backhand attack out of nowhere. Not the only German defender that can do that. We've seen Ruin Phyllis come in with some amazing backhands. Samara is so good against Chop. Doesn't do anything really that she doesn't need to. Plays really patiently. Builds up the rally till she gets the ball. She knows she can attack. And she's always had good variation in her game. She's not afraid to throw in a long serve. Not afraid to throw in a backhand topspin against heavy Chop. Goes at the back of that ball too much and she knows it. Han Ying, patient as ever, ploughing away with the chops. That kicker serve jumps up at the racket of Samara. Hits the top edge and goes off the end. Came back in game one, can she do it here in game two? Fierce forehand. No time much used yet. Seems whenever Han Ying has a lead that Samara either manages to find a net or an edge. I mean, I'm not saying she hasn't played badly, she's played brilliantly. But she's definitely had more of the luck. Play from Samara into the middle that time. The weak spot of a defender, right into the middle. He can't make a full stroke. But the chop then, Samara 7-8. Nice from Han Ying. Pounced on that one. Samara tad too negative, pays for it. Lovely use of the angle with that fade forehand I was talking about at the start. Placement over power, lovely, lovely use of the wrist to guide it with a bit of side. Nine, eight, hanging under a bit more pressure. And an impatient push from Han Ying. Samara's just had an answer whenever she's in trouble. Han Ying wins the game 11-9. We're now 1-1. Really, really hard to call this one. The head-to-heads are close. 3-2 in favour of Samara. Nothing to separate them so far. Let's see what game three has in store. Can't be helped. Nice from Han Ying. So able to play the forehand on a step around, and she usually goes cross court with it out wide. Samara's really steady on the backhand topspin and block, so that's the right tactic there from the German. What a shot from Han Ying against the net as well, and she's still there. It's such a strong relationship between the Romanian coach and players. He's got them to gold so often and must be like a father figure to these women. Lovely placement there from Samara. Fade forehand, then plays into the middle. Wang Ying goes for the big swing. It can convert the first of the two serves. Whoa! Plays it out the middle. Incredible shot from the German. Chop from Han Ying with a smooth side of the rubber. Should I say smooth side of the bat? Smooth rubber allows you to impart more chop in your initial chop than if you use the pimples. That's the benefit of twiddling on your receive. Keep things unpredictable for your opponent. They have to keep an eye on your racket and the ball, of course. And Samara doesn't even complain because she knows she's had a lot of them. Slowing it right down with those dummy loops. What a rally. Phenomenal play from Samara under pressure. Telling sign of the true champion. She was back in 2015 and still is now. The rock of that Romanian women's team. She's picking the right balls really well here in this tight stage. Not rushing, not getting tense. She takes game three. Whoa. This might have a seven setter written all over it, you know. There's something in the air. Snow comes back on the table. Now playing very calmly with the percentage, just trying to slow things down a little bit, change the pace. Nice from Samara. Playing with less power, giving Han Ying some knocking balls to try and deal with. Timeout called. Samara creeping back through, and she's playing that as though she's creeping back in. Just taking it steady, slowing things down. Changing the body language can have a big effect on how your opponent feels, and Samara's showing that right now. She's doing exactly as she needs to, nothing more, nothing less. Interesting to see what will happen after this timeout. It's not a must-win game for Han Ying, but if she can't finish this game, that's probably two sets that she feels that she should have definitely won that she couldn't. That's got to be quite taxing mentally. It's hard to brush those things aside. We're humans, not robots, at the end of the day. Great serve, completely misread from Han Ying. Timeout diffused. Should I say great serve from Samara? Oh. Bit of fortune so she doesn't celebrate the point, but what a comeback. Then a bit of a half-hearted forehand. A bit too heavy, didn't put enough legs into that, enough rotation to lift that backspin. Han Ying edges back into the lead. Samara puts away that one with a flat swat. And we're tied up at 9 points all. This is a huge moment for both players. Winner of this game could well win the match. Momentum deciding point. Wow, right off the bounce. Better timing than a Rolex. Can't take the game point. She says, maybe I should have pushed. Han Ying holds on to this fourth game. Samara not happy, but I mean, maybe it is beginning to even itself out, the look. And Han Ying takes the fourth game, just about, after Samara amounted an incredible comeback. Relief for the German. And now this match effectively becomes a best of three games. Two games all. Stay tuned for the fifth. The momentum of this match has just gone to and fro. It's not really ever been a clear favourite, and the head-to-heads are so close. Couldn't be any closer for the amount of times that they've played. Played five times, Samara's 3-2, up head-to-head. Well, that's a textbook way to play chop. Push one, attack one. Worked a treat for Samara there. Haven't seen as many attacks from Han Ying. Perhaps she's just trying to tire Samara and not give her any pace to work with. Ask Samara to do all the work. Smell goes right into the body. The last match of the day now, happening right in front of your very eyes. Who wants it more? Ooh, Samara goes for a one of the dummy loops again, slow loops. It was too heavy to do so. Didn't bring enough leg into it, enough weight transfer. She looks to have tired slightly. The Romanian. Wow. And turning passive blocking into attack. There's not many better than the former European champion, Elizabeth Samara. World class. Another 9-all, I've lost count of how many out of these five games have come to this score. Neck and neck. Such early timing, and there's the forehand of Samara, the famous forehand, fading away. Can Hang Ying stay hanging on? She can't. Samara delivers the goods in game five. And he's one game away from the last four. snow. Again, going for the slow loop, but she needs to be careful that she doesn't underestimate the amount of legs and weight she needs to put into even a shot that's a bit slower against the backspin. Whoa, straight down the line. What a forehand from Han Ying, and she does the same again. Sideswiping windscreen wiper. Well, it's looking like the final match of the day is going to go down to a final game. Yeah. Well, kind of half-hearted body language here. Is it fatigue? Both players must be really, really exhausted right now. Bit of swagger there on that Samara forehand. Oh, and a dismissive flick. Fancy, but probably too little too late right now. And indeed, we are going to a final game. Han Ying and Samara. Who dares wins in game 7? And who's got the energy? Because it's 10 o'clock in the evening local time here, and everyone in this hall is tired. It's that extra bit. Who's got that extra bit to get over the finish line? Stay tuned for the final game. helps America win this game, she will guarantee Romania at least a second place this year's European Top 16 Cup. But obviously it's an individual tournament, you're playing for yourself. Of course, though, with any sport, you're representing your country as well. This will play Bernadette Sox. An absolute marathon of a match. Oh, a side swipe and top spinning serve. Had so much on it. The worst receive we've seen from Samara. Is it a telling sign of how tired she is right now as the player change ends? 5-3 to Han Ying. The match goes to a certain length of time. Sometimes you see the expedite rule introduced, in which there's a limit on the number of shots that can be in a rally. Timeout from Samara called as she doubles the points. Han Ying doubles the points. 6-3. The ice pack on the head of Han Ying. She misses a sitter there. Timeout doesn't work yet. Hang Ying continues the streak. High chop. Samara stays patient and now she can attack. And this time she can put the icing on the cake. Samara caught a little bit flat-footed. Lovely counter from Han Ying. Into that middle question zone. 4-8. Lovely angle. The Samara special. Samara probably should have played the backhand there, but Han Ying relentless with the chopping and fantastic with the forehand counter. You just feel the 10% reserve in the energy tank coming into play. They're down to their final bits of fuel. Fatigue setting in. Match points. Samara survives. Wow. Grit, that's what champions are made of, and both players had it in this match. Han Ying had that little bit more. An epic to finish off this first and penultimate day of action here at the European Top 16. Thank you so much for joining us. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. And join us tomorrow for a fantastic final day of action. I've been your commentator, Fraser Riley. Bye-bye for now.
et c'est Monsieur Georg Schmidt là-bas en blanche avec des masques bleus.